In this video, we'll solve a vector addition problem from Beer and Johnston's statics book. I'll show you an efficient method using AutoCAD rather than calculations. Here's the problem. A barge is being pulled horizontally to the right by two tugboats, exerting tension forces T1 and T2. The resultant is a given vector of 25 kilonewtons pointing to the right. The direction of T1 is fixed at 30 degrees from the horizontal. What direction alpha would make the tension T2 a minimum? And also, what are the magnitudes of T1 and T2 when that happens? If you think about the triangle law of vector addition, if T1 is fixed in this direction and T2 plus T1 gives you this 25, there are different combinations possible. For example, this T2 plus this T1, or T2 like this and T1 like that, or this T2 plus this T1. But observe that it's when T2 is perpendicular to this T1 that it becomes the shortest. Now let's do all this on AutoCAD. Here's our AutoCAD screen. Now let's start drawing. Now first, let's turn off all the toggles on the status bar, and we'll draw the horizontal vector of 25 units. We'll go to the Home tab and push Line. Click any random starting point, and we'll push F8 to turn on the ortho mode. Then we'll type 25 to finish the line. So when you're done, just push Enter or Escape. Now you see this line looks very small. That's because the drawing board is much, much larger. To get a better view, you could either push the Zoom Extents button, or, let me undo first, you could type Z for Zoom on the command line, and then E for Extents. That allows you to see everything you have drawn so far. You could zoom out a bit. Okay. For the next step, we are now going to draw that T1 in a fixed direction. To be specific, 30 degrees from the horizontal. That means this angle here will also be 30 degrees. So to easily draw that, we could get some help by right-clicking right here and turn on the so-called polar tracking. This allows you to snap to different directions. So turn it on and make the increment angle 30 degrees. So we could snap to multiples of 30 degrees. Then click OK. When you see this is on, ortho mode is turned off automatically. Also, let's use object snap to show some endpoints. We'll right click here, and we'll choose endpoint and perpendicular, which would help us a lot in this problem. Make sure it's turned on right here, and then click OK. Now let's draw T1, or at least a vector in that direction. Line here, and snap to this endpoint. Now you see when you draw towards different directions, you could see this green line show up. And we know we want to go in the 210 degree direction. And when that happens, just click somewhere long enough. And when you click, the line is drawn. Press Escape. And then we'll go ahead and complete T2. With a line snapped to this endpoint. And now you'll see why the perpendicular snap mode will help us. When you get close to this line here, perpendicular sign shows up and you can easily click it. Now this drawn line will snap perpendicularly to the previously drawn line of T1. Now we can press Enter to come out of the command. Now it's just a matter of dimensioning those angles and lengths to find our answers. Now go to Annotate and go to Dimension. And then click Angular. This should show what the angle right here is. We know it should be 60 degrees. So we click the two lines forming the angle, and indeed, it's 60 degrees. If you don't like the appearance of this, you could always click here, and then click Modify. So since it looked too big, we could go to Fit, and type in a smaller value than 1 here. Let's say 0.2. And we'll also change a few other things. Let's change precision to 3 decimal places for both links and angles. And also I'd rather use a period than a comma as the decimal separator. And then we click OK and close. As you see, it's exactly 60 degrees. We could also label the other angles and lengths. So to dimension a length that's neither horizontal nor vertical, we could use the aligned option and snap to these two endpoints to find out. At this point, it'd be useful to turn off the perpendicular snap mode. Now we could just snap onto various endpoints to do our dimensioning. Let's do a zoom extent again. Now let's find out how much T1 is. This might be a little inconvenient, but snap on the right endpoint. So these are the answers. So let me show you one thing. We know this right here is 30 degrees. What if you wanted to dimension this exterior angle instead of this interior 30 degree angle? To do that, you just go to Angular again, and instead of picking two lines, you just push Enter to see the command line give you an option of specify vertex. So press Enter. Now you can specify the vertex here at this endpoint, and two more points that define this angle. It would be an angle here, and this endpoint here. Now you have the freedom to choose if it's an interior or exterior angle. Okay, so we're done. And we can compare these answers: 60 degrees, 12.5, and 21.65 to the answers by calculation.